So can I see the image of all while you guys are taking? I guess that you guys are taking equipment, marking it.
What the image? You're gonna load the image. When people are rest, people are there. So you now
want to do the image for the registration.
Yeah, registration.
We should do it. Hey, please, I ain't sound for it. Bring one
to the sound.
They sound it. No, sound on it. They receive it.
Hello.
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 You can't stand for it. You stand up. Do us here.
Hey, everybody,
come
downstairs.
Come
downstairs.
Come downstairs.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
I will reserve it when you all run away.
That is the man of function in which you
have people.
You know, you phone there, but your phone is not here.
No.
You are not there.
Mamãe, quer ter vez no meu corri?
Good afternoon. It's a wonderful experience once again to appear before you this time around on another issue or a series of issues. The last time I was here, I indicated to you that the next time I appear before you, there will be an arrest order or some action taken to restore law and order. Today, I have come to live up to that statement and to inform you that today, or this morning, the following radio stations, the premises of the following radio stations were ordered, searched, and equipment there seized. They are Roots FM 102.7. This action is taken pursuant to Section 15 of the Telecommunication Act of 2007, which states, and I quote, that no person shall own or operate a telecommunication network used to provide telecommunication service to the public for direct or indirect compensation except honor and in accordance with a lessen or an extension order issued by the LTA. The LTA had complained to the Ministry of Justice that for the illegal operations and the use of the frequency facilities by FM 102.7, and based on that, a formal application for a writ of section seizure was filed before His Honor Ernest B. Bannum, Sempeter Magistrate for Monrovia City Court. Based on that application, a writ of attachment, a writ of search warrant was issued and placed into the hands of the sheriff. And this morning, the sheriff, accompanied by the police, went to the premises of FM 102.7 to carry out the court order. So today's exercise was done in line with Section 11.2G of the Criminal Procedure Law, that's Title 2 Liberian Code of Law revised. We want to be categorical that in a democracy, you need legitimate and lasting institutions to operate. This radio station just means, apart from operating illegally, they were engaged in conduct of inciting, rioting, and violence. FM 102.7 specifically was engaged in broadcasting hate messages against people, against individuals, against peaceful Liberian citizens, and other forms of extortion and blackmail. This was, in my opinion, and in the opinion of the government of Liberia, a sheer public nuisance, disorderly conduct, and we could no longer condone a radio station that is now lessened, that is operating illegally to create or become an enterprise for extortion, blackmail, and name calling. These radio stations, specifically FM 102.7, has engaged in violation of Section 12.5, which is what they call advocating armed insurrection. Section 11.4, advocating armed insurrection, and aiding consummation of crimes. If you note, a few days ago, the same radio station, in the case of one Miss Justina Taylor, illegally rallied people from all over the city to converge at the Capitol Junction, illegally impede traffic, and created a state of pandemonium. That conduct is in violation of Section 12.5 of the Penal Code, and in the process, they committed crimes, throwing stones, injured police officers duly performing their state responsibility, and his conduct, the conduct of the radio station, was clearly in violation of Section 11.4 of the Penal Code. And that is advocating armed insurrection. The same radio station, by deliberately refusing to register and contribute, which is a requirement, a fundamental requirement, to operate a radio station, pay taxes, clearly undermine and sabotage the economy, engaging the theft of this equipment. As you may know, economic sabotage or theft of property is a critical offense of money laundering. And as Solicitor General, the government of Liberia intends to go a little step forward in ensuring that the kind of public nuisance and undue harassments caused by these radio stations and their owners are stopped. There will be no more instigation wherever they go, whichever radio station they use to propagate such hate messages, spread falsehood, engage in blackmail and extortion, that radio station will face the same wrath as they are today. That said, the police or the security forces have completed, with the help aiding the court, completed the search and seizure on FM 102.7. And it has come to my attention that Mr. Henry Pedro Costa is rallying and calling on his supporter to cause public unrest. I hope he understands the futility of his action. I repeat, I hope he understands the futility of his action, because it will be a serious miscalculation for he to test the resolve of this government as it relates to the current actions taken against this radio station. 102.5, I understand, is based in Harrisburg. Because it's in violation of Section 15 of the Telecommunication Act of 2007, it will be searched and the equipment there seized because they have become part of the criminal enterprise of extortion and blackmail used by this individual to propagate hate messages against innocent Liberian citizens and engage in excitement. We want to say this, that it will be a miscalculation, and we are resolved to pursue this to the end. The copy of the petition, of the writ of petition for search and seizure is here. The writ that was issued by the clerk of court of the Monroe City Court is also here. Beginning today, and to follow re-echo the statement made by the Minister of Information, Cultural Affairs and Tourism, Honorable Lei Eugene Nami, we want to say there will be no public demonstration that is not lessened and sanctioned by the government of Liberia. The Public Order Act of 1975, which is called an act to obtain permit to stage public demonstration, will be upheld. Any demonstration that is not lessened or sanctioned by the government of Liberia will be considered illegal, and the demonstrator will face the full weight of the law. There will be no blinking, there will be no joking this round. All those who were arrested during the recent demonstration at the Capitol Junction will be prosecuted, and I have instructed the county attorney for Mosorado County to prepare the appropriate indictment against Mr. Costa and all those who have been collaborating with him to engage in blackmail and extortion against unsuspecting citizens in this country. This decision is clearly supported by the Honorable Minister of Justice and Attorney General, my boss. He and I were on the same page. So everything I say here, clearly, he supports that. Having said that, I want to shift my focus. I want to shift my focus to the situation in the LMA, the Liberia Marketing Association. In deference to the court, the Honorable Supreme Court of Liberia, the government of Liberia
decided to reinstate the current president after the rather wild situation that led to her removal. The court instructed that she should be reinstated and she should benefit and enjoy the luxurious trappings of power associated with her office. Immediately upon the assumption of office, she misled a group of police officers and began to beat people. And in the process, broke the arm of one Majenowe Caesar. And then, in the process, she started to put people she believed who were opposed to her in arms way. The situation at the Liberal Marketing Association is so disturbing that many of the marketers have come to the office of the Solicitor General or the Ministry of Justice to complain. The authority of the court to order a reinstatement was not met that she would be carried along with her police officers assigned to her and taking instructions from her to beat people and in the process break the hand or broke the arm of one Majenowe Caesar. That situation clearly suggests to all that she lacks the authority to govern. As a government, she has already been indicted for financial fraud and misapplication of entrusted funds, along with some members of the board. That leadership can no longer exercise the function of the office. I, therefore, given the gravity of the situation, in consultation with the Minister of Internal Affairs, direct that she stay away from that office henceforth. Any attempt to unduly use of power, though indicted, and to try to deplete the coffers of the Liberal Marketing Association, certainly will not go down with her. And therefore, she has become a total desperado to the image of the Liberal Marketing Association. She can no longer exercise her function. The authority of the court was that she be given the opportunity to take seat. The court did not say she should have the authority to break the arm of other people or beat people. The Honorable Supreme Court would never instruct that. We are picking between stability, sanity, and the kind of insanity that we have seen at the Liberal Marketing Association. And therefore, she will not be allowed to go back to that office. She has been indicted for financial fraud to exercise control over the coffers of the Liberal Marketing Association. And any attempt besides today, beyond this statement, or to perform an act in that direction will be arrested. That said, the Ministry of Internal Affairs will find the appropriate president to stay until the elections. Coming back to the issue of the radio station, the one key issue that attracts the attention of the government of Liberia, and that is, when Justina Taylor was at the Kepler Hospital, Henry Costa called on the radio and rallied all those that he could rally. And among them were ladies, many of them wearing the same type of lapa. But we noticed that these ladies, many of them came from a group called WebNet. And what we did was to monitor the activities of those women who took part in the public demonstration. The right to freely assemble is constitutional, but the freedom of assembly is not constitutionally sacrosanct. It means it's not absolute, meaning it goes with responsibility. You must apply for permit and be allowed to assemble freely and carry out public demonstrations and matches. But these ladies from Whitney, whether it was done with the acquiescence of the leadership, clearly assembled, engaging all forms of invectives, vulgarity, and disorderly conduct. And thereafter, the activities were monitored, and at the end of the day, they went inside Elfi, where they went to share their spoil for trying to destabilize the peace of the state. In the process, a Liberian citizen decided to video frame them. When he did that, and in the process when they realized that they were being filmed, they raised alarm and he left. They claimed they were not involved with anything, but in the night, in the middle of the night, late as 10 p.m., they took with them a group of men to the home, to the place where a Liberian citizen was residing by the name of Vama Bobby Gray. And they said, if you do not apologize or erase what you framed, this will be your last time ever to do it. And they claimed they came from the Liberian National Police at that time of the night. With them was a lady called Delphine Morris Jokai. They sent Delphine Morris Jokai, read a press statement on the social media. But what is amazing is that she claimed that the police wanted to arrest Vama Bobby Gray, and she was there in the night with the people that went there in plain clothes. And when she realized that Vama Bobby Gray was filming them, she ran away. I want to say this. She will have to produce the police, the purported police that she took on the scene. I am told that she's on her way to Lofa to Divine Rest. I have instructed the county attorney upon site to arrest her and bring her to Monrovia to be questioned. I'm not sure this is the objective of Whitney. This morning, I ordered that she appear at my office. I stayed there all too long, she never showed up. Well, the authority of the Solicitor General or the Ministry of Justice starts and ends wherever the Republic starts and ends. Wherever she turned out, whether in Banga, the county attorney in Banga will have to arrest her and bring her to Monrovia. We can't condone lawlessness. That said, this brings me to another key issues I wanted to share with you this morning, this afternoon. A few days ago, the government of Liberia received a petition, an application from the ECOWAS Court filed by Impeach Justice Mohamed Kabina Janet, or Kabina Mohamed Janet. What is so sickening about the petition is not the fact that he said there was no fair trial, but an NGO called International Legal Assistance Consortium proffered an affidavit or a letter in support of the fact that the entire trial was nothing but a kangaroo. And so many debasing and condescending comments are contained in the petition. The NGO alleges that the letter is simply based on a perception of people. Yesterday, the NGO organized a workshop in which the Ministry of Justice was invited and people were expected to make comments or raise some fundamental concerns about the alleged inadequacies of the judiciary, Liberian judiciary. And in attendance at that meeting, at that conference, was the Honorable Minister of Justice, Attorney General, and the Solicitor General of this Republic. The Attorney General was alerted about the debasing comments made by the NGO before the ECOWAS score against the sovereign state of the Republic. And in clear discharge of his responsibility as Attorney General and legal advisor to the government of Liberia, he there and there walked out of the conference in protest. I have indicated to him that walking out is not sufficient. We cannot lessen or grant a permit to an NGO in our country, and when a citizen of ours who attempted to abuse a national agenda is being punished because of his miscalculation, then there is a foreign institution that tried to aid and abet his conduct before a sovereign power with the sole intent to belittle and demean the sovereignty of our country. I have communicated with the authority at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs seeking to review the permit of ILAC, International Legal Assistance Consortium, to have seen revoked. ILAC is no longer a neutral party. It is party to be sued against the Republic of Liberia. I told you why to bring it to your attention. I am a European lawyer, so too is Councillor Johnson. I don't see which legal system in Europe that is so credible and better than ours. For example, in Italy, when a matter is called, one of the judges who have presided along with another judge will form part of the team of jurors to go in the jury room to make a deliberation. We don't have that here. We don't have that here. So, if a Liberian citizen said he was never given a fair trial, and you know impeachment proceedings are political proceedings, doesn't require an NGO to form part of that Liberian citizen to cast aspersion on the credibility of our legal system, especially the judiciary? I said no. I think their conduct is atrocious, unacceptable, and cannot be condoned. That said, I will now take a few questions and then leave for my assignment. Thank you.
So those of you that have questions, you please come forth. We have a queue. Come for no prepaids or prepaids before your question. You can try to ask a question.
Let me take our most serious questions. So I can
serious question, one person, one question.
Used to propagate hate messages have been seized. Now, the grounds for the seizure is that it is illegal. It's in contravention of Section 15 of the Telecommunications Act of 2007. Now, Root FM is not. If Root FM is in violation of the Freedom FM is in violation, then in that way, because there will be a corporation there, that's an appropriate procedure of going after a corporate body. But when you are operating illegally, we have another way of going after you. So there's a difference or a distinction between Freedom FM and Root FM.
Next question.
Good morning, sir. I'm Chogon Flama in a report for Fabric. My attention has been drawn to the closure of Roots FM. Before reaching to this point, of closing the station, did the government receive any letter from the station for reapplying for license renewal or anything as such?
Thank you. I think the FM people will be the best. You know, it's everything they call best evidence principle. They will say this is a letter we wrote, but not to my knowledge.
Next question.
My name is Sam Gedro. I'm from the Radio Radio, basically, University. You are talking about indicting Harold Costa. Now he's an entering country. He's being in the United States. How do you bring back, you know, how do you indict him, which Henry Costa when he's not here? Maybe he can use other frequency of this closing administration after inciting people in this country. So, is it McKenzie are you going to put in place for getting Henry Costa over to Nigeria?
You raise a very good point. You say he will use other frequency. Let me repeat. If any radio station allows Mr. Costa to reduce its frequency to a criminal enterprise of extortion and blackmail, we will go after you because you will be the conduit through which he propagates his wicked intention, a vicious campaign, a callous disregard for constitutional authority, and its reckless and irresponsible behavior of harassing and unduly extorting information and money from people.
Next question.
I'm John Sharif. I'm working for ECOWAS Radio. I'd just like to know if you're going to allow Mr. Costa into the country to sort of defend himself with respect to the closure of the station. What preceded was some explanation he made regarding what was being comported, according to him, by the justice, by the government of Liberia through the justice minister, to close down a few stations, including his. And what I got from your very beautifully delivered speech is that you talk more about Costa and the other stations.
No, I said, I listed a number of radio stations, and I said, the same thing that went on at Roots FM will be done to FM 102.5, or FM 102.1, and others that we did not need. Now, under our law, Ms. Nama is not a defense. So I can say others will be identified. If we find you in that category, beginning today, starting from tomorrow, the Office of the Solicitor General will listen to all the radio stations. And if you propagate hate messages and believing that by using those messages as a form of extortion and blackmail, trust me, you'll find yourself in the dark.
And my first question, are you going to allow him to come freely to come and, you know?
Well, when people are indicted, indictment is simply a set of allegations that still will have to be proved in court. Yeah.
Okay, good afternoon, sir. My name is Nelson Colette, and I work for Fiverr Radio. Okay, I listened to you very carefully when you talked about the reasons why the Roots FM is now, you know, being closed down by the government. And one of the reasons you stated is the station being used by, you know, the talk show host to incite people and so forth. But I'd like to know, recently there was another issue with the Freedom FM, where the institution also incited people, peaceful citizens of this country, to protest against an entity, No Star Selling Tea. What was your stance as Solicitor General of Liberia in that case?
I have said there's a line of distinction between Roots FM and what you call Freedom FM. One is legal. When a corporation, for example, under Chapter 15 of the Criminal Procedure Law, if we find any reason that Root of Freedom FM commits a crime, there are procedures through which we can follow. The difference between Freedom FM and Roots FM is that Freedom FM is lessened and was never listed by LTA in its complaint to the Ministry of Justice. Now, if you have an idea
or any information or a compelling evidence to prove to me that Freedom FM is legally operating that has not been brought to the certain knowledge of the FTA, make it public and you will see the same thing we're doing. Now, on the issue that you allege that you were engaging in incitement, I'm not aware. First, the Office of the Solicitor General is not so sophisticated to the extent that they will be listening to 100 radio stations at the same time. It's not possible. The only way the Office of the Solicitor General or the Ministry of Justice or the Office of the Attorney General will be able to act will be based on complaint. In a case involving Henry Costa, it is a known fact that he's a nuisance. His conduct, his behavior, not him as a person, but his activities. So what we did is that we seized those equipment that have become a criminal enterprise for the propagation of hate messages. Now, if all of the equipment have been seized and you call that a closure of Roots FM, so be it. Even the generator that generates power for you to engage in a conduct of blackmail should be seized. So he doesn't have generator, he doesn't have transmission, he doesn't have it. So how does he operate? We have to act as a government. And I want to say this. He has followers. Starting now, I learned this morning he was on the air calling his followers to come around. When I leave from here, I will call the Inspector General of Police and the Deputy Inspector General to find out whether any arrest was made. If an arrest was made of any person, trust me, you will regret ever to assemble illegally without acquiring document or permit to do so. From now on, every public demonstration will have to be detected by the Ministry of Justice through the Office of the Solicitor General. If you want to demonstrate, you get a permit, we can send you to Bokolima. And say, go and demonstrate in Bokolima or in Bijota in Grand Basso. Or we say, go and demonstrate in Kaloken, Maryland County. Or we say, go and demonstrate in Talobengo in Foya District near the border. You want to demonstrate as a Republic of Liberia? But you cannot continue to impede the free movement of citizens. There are so many Liberians and so many foreign residents in our country who want to see life go on and don't want to see the kind of disturbances that we've seen around here. We should give credit to the president for being a leader who is tolerant. Before, Mr. Costa would never have the kind of platform that he enjoys over the last 8 months. At one point, he wanted to demonstrate, he called a COP. At another point, he wanted to demonstrate on July 31. Now I'm hearing, he said he's doing this. Starting from now on, it becomes the sole responsibility of the government of Liberia to protect every Liberian citizen. He will not have the platform to engage in blackmail and extortion. Now, beginning today, so all those who support him and all those who honor the voice, honor my voice, anywhere listening around the world, please advise Costa and collaborators that gone are those days when he used to have a free will. The last thing I want to say before I close on your question, I have instructed the county attorney this morning that whenever the police is about to perfect a legally sanctioned action, Mr. Costa will rally thugs and hooligans and bums and goons to call and cause chaos. And in their presence, there will be a lawmaker appearing, and he tries, always tries to address the press. That lawmaker, you please advise him. The next time he crosses the red line, you have to confront the law. Part of the lawmaking does not extend to the point to support illegal demonstration. Part of the lawmaking does not extend to the point to support anyone who tries to subvert, engage in conduct to undermine the Constitution. Please, you are a violent lawmaker, whoever he is.
that said, I also want to say that I come here. We are, for example, I am Solicitor General because there's a government that sanctioned my being Solicitor General. If you want to put your one foot to the people who want to undermine the authority of this government, and at the same time want to put your one foot into the government, you have to come clean. You either with us or you are against us. You can't be with us and aiding and abetting people and trying to play clean. One day the day I appear, Aaron will speak to some of the issues. Any more questions, you guys have to leave.
Yeah, just a follow-up, sir. Recently, the FTA, there was a report that they conducted a survey, and they got to know that about 79 radio stations in this country, they operate illegally. Why are you only concerned about the Roots FM? What happens to the rest of the other stations?
I thought I answered this question. I said misnomer in law is not a defense. So for example, we don't name you. Now let me send out a strong warning. If you are operating illegally and you were not searched and your premises were not searched today, I advise you to go to LTA and start to register. In fact, I want to commission the press to be the watchdog. To help identify those radio stations that are not registered that are operating, because everybody is doing interactive program now. When we catch you operating illegally, you will pay. Because we're very resolved. So all the radio stations that are operating illegally, that are not lessened by the government of Liberia through the LTA, starting from today, you either stop your broadcast and go to the FTA to register, or if they bring the information to us and we find it out, it will be a serious, serious mistake on your part. You will regret. So don't make us to find you. Bring yourself out, come into the open and say, look, I've been doing this illegally, but I think today is about time to do it right. I want to say thank you very much. It was a rewarding experience. It was good that nobody asked me questions about ARED, because the chairman of ARED, as well as the official spokesman.